Johnson. I am the CEO of Racial Justice Network, which is a civil rights organization. The family came for answers. They need answers and need closures. So they drove down from South Carolina wanting to know what happened to their loved one. We had a meeting today with Captain Taylor, who can tell us much about what happened, simply because he said that FBI is doing the investigation so they can tell us how, if anything, which the family were not satisfied with their were saying.
Hello, my name is Jeanette. I'm the wife of Lucius Gibbs. We've been married 36 years. He's and from what I know, for knowing him, he's a very outgoing, big-hearted person. He would do anything you need to do, any work that you need him to do. He was an entrepreneur. He traveled with his work, and he had a big heart. He loved his family. He loved his children. He loves me. And I just listened, and all today that I want done is justice. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Paul Anthony Scott. I'm the brother of Walter Scott, and we grew up with Lucius Benjamin Gibbs, my cousin. And he wasn't only my cousin, but he was my brother cousin. I knew him ever since I was 5 years old. We used to play and dig, fish, and do lots of great things together. It's gonna be a tremendous loss for not only our community, but all our family, because he was not only a brother, a cousin, a father, a grandfather, but he was also a friend. He was a mentor. And being the mentor that he was controlled. He controlled the situation. He was a voice to be reckoned with. And we're gonna tremendously miss him, but what we're here today is we need truth and we need answers. And we'll be here until we can get those things, because we need closure for his children, for his grandchildren, and for his wife.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Marvin Pendarvis. I'm a member of the South Carolina House of Representatives. I'm also a member of the Racial Justice Network's legal team. But more importantly, I'm a husband, a father, a son, a brother, a friend. All of those things that Mr. Gibbs was. We understand that this is currently being investigated by the Alabama Law Enforcement Agency, or a division of that, and they've got the investigation and are looking into the facts. And we understand that there are multiple allegations that there were shots fired, there was a handgun that was in his hand, and there was a long rifle that was on the passenger seat. And so the question we have, and one of the things that, you know, I've been a big proponent of is, you know, we want truth and transparency. And we're asking the sheriff's office if they believe that their officers were in the right and they should be exonerated of any kind of wrongdoing, and release the video. Give this community, give this family some sense of closure as to what happened so that we can see and we can dissect.
In the meeting this morning, Captain Taylor told the family that the officer is back on duty patrolling the community. In other states, he don't go back on duty until the investigation is over. But they back on duty patrolling the area. And that's new to me in all the states I've been to, that they remain on leave until the investigation is over. So
the National Racial Justice Network motto is death requires responsibility. The life is taken. Someone needs to be held accountable. We're not here to point fingers at anyone. We just want whatever happened to be disclosed in a timely fashion. Body cam videos, dash cam videos, 911 calls, incident reports, autopsy. We would like everything to be released immediately to the family so that we can see for ourselves exactly what happened. If there's nothing to hide, please release it. We would also like the name of the officer that was involved. We would like his name as well, or her name. Death requires responsibility.